You know, the debates that this game had espoused is rather hilarious to me. The funniest thing about the whole deal are the people who never even played this game. Some of them have never even owned the PS2. And they refer to IGN and GameSpot reviews to prove their argument, which is, Killzone sucks, it's not Halo. You know, most Killzone haters will make a reference to Halo when talking about this game, believing that Killzone was marketed as the Halo killer. The funny thing is that it was the game media that asked, will this game kill Halo? Hundreds of times, but the developers of Killzone themselves, Guerrilla Games, never once mentioned Halo when marketing this game, if you remember it back then. It was the game media that hyped it up as a Halo killer, not the developers nor the publishers themselves. Please remember that. As for the question, the media has never given up. Of course, this game is no Halo killer. But is it really that terrible as everyone says it is? Well, here is an in-depth opinion from someone who beat Killzone 3 times and know the game pretty much inside and out. When you pop the disc into your PS2, make sure to watch the intro scene before starting the game. It's chillin'. The intro speed is pretty much the best cutscene in the entire game. It also provides massive amounts of information about the game's story. It tells you that in the very distant future, as humanity branched out to other planets and other galaxies, some people were morphed into beings now called Helgans, due to the harsh environmental pressures of certain planets. Humanity, fearing Helgans, left them to dry and forgot about them. Helgans just wanted to be treated like human beings, but the deformity only aroused neglect and betrayal. Fed up with all this bullshit, a leader rises up out of the Helgan ranks, building up a massive Helgan army and wages war on their former human brothers. This caused the Helgan War and is the backbone of the story of the Killzone universe. Just from that intro Helgan speech, it will be easy to notice that the story of this game is not just the usual cookie-cutter story, but something that was thought out pretty thoroughly, and one that is presented in an intriguing manner. It also does a lot of parallel to World War II, which I found was pretty interesting and very symbolic. The problem, though, is that the same quality of presentation is lost halfway through the game, and the ending moments of the game are really disappointing when it comes to the cutscene and the story. However, for a first-person shooter, the story of this game is a commendable feature, and is actually pretty deep, at least the beginning parts. What docked massive amounts of points for this game, though, was probably the gameplay. The game has a great story, lots of new innovative features such as being able to play as one of the 4 different characters with different attributes and different abilities, each with different branchable path, and unique and fun level design. But the game is marked by 2 simple things: enemy AI and controls. It's really weird that the game tackles so many unique, never been tried before aspects extremely well, and yet fails to execute well the basic elements necessary to a shooter. The enemy AI isn't laughably horrible, but then I'd be lying if I didn't say that it was lacking. Oh, it's lacking. It's great that Guerrilla Games wanted to implement a stealth element to the enemy AI. They act differently when they think they see you and when they think you don't even exist. But I think that trying to make such a complex AI was too ambitious for them. Once discovered, it's often pretty funny seeing how they respond to you. They pretty much just run, hide behind something, and shoot. That's pretty much there is to the enemy AI. And sometimes it's kind of glitchy, because sometimes they think they haven't discovered you even though you're standing right in front of them. So it's easy to just knife them, you know? The controls, while pretty solid, it's nowhere near as fluid as a game like, well, I guess I gotta compare it, Halo. Yeah, this is the only aspect of the game that it is okay to compare Halo to. The sensitivity is a bit too stiff. It's really stiff in Killzone. And the way sniping is done is really piss poor. There is no jump button, so a lot of times you're resorted to taking the long route, even though a jump button would have easily made a shortcut, like overcoming this pass right here, but you have to make long route around. Just doesn't make any sense. The melee controls are a bit unusual, and sometimes even glitchy, and the controls for changing weapons could have been a whole lot better, just doesn't feel smooth. But I don't think those 2 flaws warrant such a comment as Killzone sucks. On the contrary, Killzone does not suck. It implements some of the coolest things to be shown in a first-person shooter. The 4 different characters you get to try out are really unique, and even offer a great incentive to replay the game again. like playing a level as a grunt, like Rico, and then replaying the level as a spy really makes you like you're feeling you're playing a whole different other game or a whole other level. The grunt can blow away obstacles with his rocket launcher slash chain gun, which will allow him to use certain routes. The spy, on the other hand, can crawl and climb through spots that are inaccessible to other characters. Also, the armed with a knife and a dermal goggle, stealth is of utmost importance to the spy, and that was something that I thought was a breath of fresh air in this first-person shooter, because it's not just about shooting. Depending on which character you have to utilize stealth. If you're using Rico, it's just run and shoot and gun and blow everything up. If you're playing as Luger, who's the spy, you know, you're using stealth. You're crawling away and you're actually avoiding confrontation. If you're using Haka, you're hacking equipments and you're disguising yourself as the enemy. I mean, it's just so unique. And every single level, pretty much, except for like the first three levels, offers all these branching paths for all different characters, which I thought was just remarkably well done. And the level design is fantastic in that aspect. So, in that sense, level design really heightens the replay value, and Killzone, in my opinion, is one of the most fun and unique single-player FPS experiences to be created. There's one more flaw, though, that I have not yet gone over, and that is the multiplayer. It is unfortunately unpolished and unfinished and just incomplete. Killzone was released too early, and Guerrilla Games was not able to fully implement the multiplayer, so they just made it an option to play certain maps with bots. The thing is, you can't really customize anything about the multiplayer. You can't set what weapons there will be in the map, what starting weapons there will be, game modes, or anything like that. The only thing you're allowed to change is your team, Helgen or ISA, and the amount of bots in the map. What does that mean? Well, after you play the multiplayer for about like 30 minutes, or maybe even an hour, you'll be bored, because you'll be tired of doing the same shit over and over again. And you'll want to start another game. Multiplayer would be better also if it wasn't so glitchy. I honestly think this game should have come out, should have just not come out with this tacked on feature. No multiplayer. I don't know, maybe, well, some people enjoy the multiplayer Killzone 2 with friends. But it just, like, you know, it just feels so tacked on and so incomplete. The potential is like, I don't know, there isn't even evidence of potential. It's just there. Just like, here's the bare bones multiplayer that you could play for 30 minutes. That's pretty much it. If you're going to release that section so unpolished, why not just forget about it altogether? So anyway, here's the conclusion. Killzone is a really great single-player experience with a gripping story, at least for the first half, and a unique level design and lots of amount of innovations. Its only flaws are with the controls that take really getting used to, and the enemy AI. It completely fails in the multiplayer aspect, but it is no way a game that sucks. Just because an FPS game is not as great as Halo, doesn't mean that it sucks.